Hi, welcome to Wellness. I'm your host, Linda Lonergan, Senior Clinical Nutritionist. I'm here to show you the very best your community has to offer in health, fitness, wellness, amazing events, and great people. I am joined by one of those amazing people, a lovely RD, and her name is Carrie.
Hi, Linda. Thanks for having me on the show. I'm very excited to be here today.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Great. So you do so many things, Carrie. You really do.
I do.
But you work with a very special group or a population. Can you share with me?
Yes, I work for Constructive Partnerships Unlimited, which we work with individuals with disabilities, cerebral palsy, Prader-Willi, all kinds of different needs nutritionally and physically. So it's a great organization that I work for now. We know we have a speech therapist that I work closely with and several nurses, house managers. We all work together and I'm in charge of the nutrition and the food. And I get a menu through an organization in the city that has 100 group homes. So I have 11 up here in the Hudson Valley that I take care of.
Wow.
So it's, yes, it's been a challenge, but it's been great. And I really feel like I'm making a difference in that population. So,
you certainly are.
Yeah. And I just love the individuals that I work with.
Right.
And you know, the diets range from pureed to regular to cut up to, we have tube feedings. We have all kinds of nutrition needs.
Right.
So,
what are some important nutritional parameters for people with cerebral palsy?
I think the most important thing is it's very extremely individualized.
Right.
The office with OWDD, they have specific guidelines, like some people can only handle quarter-inch pieces or some need a puree or a ground. Thickened liquids are an issue for some people.
Right.
So we have honey, nectar, pudding, thick liquids. We try to be the most, I don't want to say normal, but as least restrictive as possible with their diets.
Right.
But also flavor. Making a variety of foods for them. So, because they're just individuals like us and they want, you know, food to taste good, even if it is cut up or pureed or ground.
Right.
So, and so, making sure they're hydrated.
Right.
I'm all about getting plenty of fruits and vegetables in them, even if they are pureed or ground. It's still important to,
you know. The colors of the rainbow.
The colors of the rainbow. Yeah. Yes, that's my thing.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, every individual has specific nutrition needs, and that's what we've been working towards. It's only been 3 months, but, you know, we've made a lot of progress already. So
yeah, and I'm sure every single one in the dedication and time that you put in everything you do, which is obvious, I'm sure you're putting as much dedication time into helping them as well, and you're touching so many lives. Because if you can make something that's palatable but satiating, but at the same time calorically beneficial with adequate protein, but I'm sure you're working very, very hard at it.
Yes, I'm trying.
Yeah, and it's quite a challenge.
And I love it because it has my food service background.
Right.
You know, as a food service director and as a registered dietitian, you know, for all these years, I'm able to bring all my skills into this job and use a variety of different skills, because you know RDs are very vast in their skill set. So
absolutely.
So it is nice to be able to use all my background as well
to interplay into the whole thing. I remember I worked as a food service supervisor as an RD in a nursing home in White Plains. And it was amazing that I didn't think that was going to interplay. I never thought examining tray lines and also inspecting diet cards at the same time was going to be something part of what I did.
Yeah.
But you're absolutely right that as RDs and nutritionists, we have a tremendous diversification that can be applied. We're not just people in terms of just losing weight or gaining weight. Yep. We go above and beyond that.
Because I've done geriatrics for 20 years, let's say. So it's all it all comes down to good nutrition and meeting people what their diet needs are too. So, you know, so it was a nice change to go from geriatrics, though I do love my geriatric patients. But this is a nice change.
Yeah. You're helping a different sector of the population.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So the important things is, adequate hydration, adequate texture in terms of, what their limit is to swallowing.
Yep, exactly.
And also satiation and palatability, if they have the inability to chew, as far as how ground it is or what the texture is, properties.
And weight loss and weight gain.
Weight loss.
You know, we do have, you said you went to Pittsburgh, the University of Pittsburgh, the children's diet, they have the red, yellow, green diet, which is for the Prader-Willi. So hoping to go down and receive more education on that, because that has made a tremendous difference in several. We've had individuals lose 150 pounds, 100 pounds. It's really remarkable how much that diet does help. And then the structure and consistency with that population has, you know, they exercise. I said, I'm going to move into the house because they exercise every day when they get home for program for 20 to half hour. Right. You know, their meals are beautiful salmon and just vegetables and fruit, and just very, very controlled and consistent. And that seems to what really has helped them.
It makes a difference. Can you explain to my viewers exactly what that is?
Prader-Willi?
Right.
The main thing is that they are, become obsessed with food. They don't want, they never become satisfied with food. So it's something that they think about all the time. And they will go to a lot of means to get food to satisfy that hunger. So it also comes with some developmental disabilities and other issues. But for as a nutritionist and a dietitian, it's really setting boundaries with food and limits, and then the exercise, because they, a lot of them have very short stature, so it's hard to burn calories. And as they're aging and getting older, as we all know, it is harder to burn calories. So exercise is extremely important in motivating them to just move more.
Right.
I have one individual that loves to dance, and she's like, "Dancing is exercise, right?" And I said, "Absolutely, it's my favorite kind of exercise."
Yeah.
So,
and the delineation of the three colors, what does that apply to?
It's the foods. Green foods are go. You can have as many foods of that, vegetables, as much as you want. Yellow is, you need to be cautious. Like banana would be a yellow food because you just can't do. And then the red would be, which they're allowed once a month or for special occasions, would be a donut or apple pie or something. So it's very limited to, you know, how much of that they can have. So I think we could all use a little red, yellow, green in our lives.
Absolutely. And you know what I like about it is simplistic. A lot of times with my patients, it's very overwhelming for them, no matter what design I design, or meal plan I make for them. And something red, green, yellow seems
simplistic, but to the point. It really is. And and they know, the individuals know, like we're already planning the December red food because they like to do it as a group. So they'll go out to a restaurant and they'll all have their red food that day. So we were just, I was just on the phone with the house manager discussing what the red food was going to be for the month. So, you know, and they definitely, there's cheating. They sometimes cheat, but a lot of them are very honest. Like, you know, I just stole five puddings. So, cause I was hungry. They're honest. And then you just try to educate them and, you know, it happens. It happens. So,
And it's part, and one of the things I love about you is I try as an RD and nutritionist to put myself out there as many places as I can to teach about nutrition and well-being. And you do the same. You just finished up an amazing retreat.
The amazing women's retreat. Yes. It was
to do with nutrition, wellness.
Actually, I think next year I will do a part on nutrition. I tend to not, I gather people together and find resources, and women love to talk, so they help each other so much grow.
That's so great.
So much to grow. Yeah, we had amazing speakers. And then just, you know, the first question I asked is, what's amazing about you? And some people couldn't even answer that.
So
and then
true.
It was just so hard to watch. And then I think, well, that was me, you know, 2 years ago. So by the end of the retreat, I asked one of the participants, well, what's amazing about you? And she's like, I came to this retreat. I have friends. I'm amazing. So it was that quick. Like, you know, in 8 hours, people really felt supported and were very excited to be there and be a part of it. So, and they're like, are you doing this next year, right? So November 1st, I think, will be my third amazing women's retreat. So
and you helped so many.
Yep.
You have so many.
Thank you. And hopefully you can be there and you can be supportive too.
I do want to. I got involved with business after coming back from Europe. But,
yeah, your trip.
I had heard all about it. It's wonderful what you do and what you keep doing.
Yep.
And good luck with this new position. You know,
thank
these
you.
Are such vital, such beautiful people that need so much help.
Yeah.
You're the very best to do it.
Thank you. Thank you, Linda.
No, absolutely.
Very nice to work with you.
I want to thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Carrie Wansenberger. And I wish you the very best in everything you do.
Thank you, you
for being here.
All right. Great. Thank you.
Remember, when you eat well and select great foods and feel great, it's something you want to do for the rest of your life. I want to thank my wonderful crew. Have a nice evening. Good night.